अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन दिस सेकंड वीडियो ऑफ वीक नंबर 4। इन फर्स्ट वीडियो वी हैव सीन दैट द नियर टू फार रेशियो एज मेजर्ड बाय द टूल इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू न्यूट्रॉन पोरोसिटी यूजिंग दिस ग्राफ। ऑन वाई एक्सिस यू हैव नियर टू फार रेशियो, ऑन एक्स एक्सिस यू हैव द न्यूट्रॉन पोरोसिटी एंड दिस इज द मैट्रिक्स लाइन। यू अज्यूम अ मैट्रिक्स एंड बेसिकली यू कन्वर्ट नियर टू फार रेशियो इनटू पोरोसिटी। बेसिकली in generalized form you have all the matrix line available for the conversion from neutron near to far ratio into the porosity. Different, as mentioned written over here, that different calibration line exists for different matrix type: limestone, sandstone, dolomite. The neutron porosity on the log will always have an indication of which of these three lithologies was assumed, and generally as written that normally the logger, basically the logger which is using this near to far, near far ratio and converting this near far ratio into porosity, that logger will always use this limestone as a matrix for this conversion. And whatever the matrix he has chosen, that particular lithology will be written on the log header, that neutron porosity is reported against which lithology. So this is a summary that the count rates at the near and far detectors are measured. A ratio of these is then taken. The ratio is translated into porosity using a transform and generally using the limestone matrix line. The current field output for the thermal neutron porosity is called N5 neutron porosity, or now more usually TNPH, thermally neutron porosity. And basically when the logs have been provided to you, you basically from the log header you basically see that this neutron porosity is reported in limestone unit, and when you have identified that this is the sandstone or dolomite, so you will convert your porosity, neutron porosity value for that particular lithology using this slide or using this graph, and this is called lithology correction graph. And on this graph you can see on x-axis you have the neutron log porosity value, and you have different lines for different lithology, for sandstone, limestone, dolomite, and you entered from your log value from the x-axis. For example, 30% porosity basically has been recorded in limestone unit, and when you identify it is a sandstone, you entered from x-axis and reached to the sandstone matrix line, and from y-axis you measure the true porosity in that particular lithology. So 35% porosity was the true porosity of that sandstone formation, and on the log 30% neutron porosity value was recorded. So this is the graph for correcting the porosity once you identify the lithology of that particular zone. We will be seeing in the coming slide. So for example, you have been asked to read the neutron porosity values in zone number 1, zone number 7 and zone number 11 using neutron porosity log. So the log section have been given to you. Different zones have been already made for your easiness, but remember that many times you will not be provided with zones. You will be giving a generalized log section and you need to make zones by yourself. But in this log section, zones have been made for your easiness. So zone number 1 to 11 and all log responses against each zone have been given to you. So on track number 1 you have gamma ray, caliper and bit size. On track number 2 and 3 combined you have density and neutron log. On track number 2 you have PEF log, and on track number 3 you have density correction log. So we have studied all these log, and only the neutron log in this log session we are studying now. And you have been asked to calculate the neutron porosity values in zone number 1, zone number 7 and zone number 11 using neutron porosity value. So again, scale you have to see the scale of the neutron log from the log header. So the scale is from 45% till minus 15%, and again the neutron value is decreasing from left side to right side. The neutron log basically is reported in limestone unit. So you need to correct when you have sandstone or dolomite. So the reported porosity is in limestone unit, and the scale is from 45% to minus 15%, and basically the minimum maximum is 60%, and you have four boxes, so each box will be equal to 15. So 45% on the left side, at first box line, the neutron value will be 30. On the second box line, the neutron value will be 15. On the third box line, the neutron value will be 0%. So that's how neutron value is changing. So first you read, we know that before estimating porosity, first task is to identify the lithology. And lithologies can be identified through gamma ray log, PEF log, and some lithologies can be identified through density log. So these logs we have studied till now: gamma ray log, PEF log, and density log. We haven't yet studied the density neutron cross plot, but we will be seeing in coming slide that the density neutron cross plot can also be used to identify the lithologies. In other words, basically it can be used to confirm the lithologies you have estimated through PEF log. So you estimate lithologies from PEF log, you estimate lithologies from density cross plot, and then basically you try to match these lithologies. If both answers are same, which means you have accurately identified the lithology. But if PEF is giving you sandstone, density cross plot is giving you limestone, which means something is wrong and you need to go back and look into the log responses again. So first we need to identify lithologies by gamma ray log, PEF log, and density log. Zone number 1, 7, and 11 all have very low gamma ray values. These zones are all non-shaley zone. Since we know that gamma ray log basically is used to differentiate between shale and non-shaley zone, so zone number 1, 7, and 11 all have very low gamma ray value, so which means that they are at least non-shaley zones. And zone number 1 is limestone. PEF value is 5, and with density and neutron value. Zone number 1, basically we have also done this example when we were studying PEF log. So zone number 1 is at zone number 1, the PEF value is 5. The scale is from 0 to 5, and the value is on the extreme right of track number 2. So PEF value in zone number 1 is 5, and we have seen that PEF value 5 can only be in limestone, salt, and anhydrite. There are three lithologies in which you can have PEF value is equal to 5. But in salt, you have a specific density. In anhydrite, you have a specific density. So by knowing the density values, we come to conclusion that zone number 1 is limestone, because the PEF value is 5 and the density of this zone is different than the density of salt and anhydrite zone. Zone number 7 and 11 are sandstone. The PEF value in zone number 7 and 11 are 2. You can see zone number 7 has a PEF value of 2. Similarly, zone number 11 has a PEF value of 2. And since we know from the PEF log that whenever you have a PEF value equal to 2, it is most likely sandstone. So low gamma ray value, PEF value is equal to 2, it's most likely the sandstone. Again, density neutron cross plot can also be used to confirm these lithologies, but since we haven't studied till now, so we will not be using it right now. So after identifying the lithologies, read the neutron porosity value in each zone. So zone number 1 has a neutron porosity value around 30, zone number 7 9, and zone number 11 neutron porosity value is 18. So you can read it from the log section. Zone number 11 has a neutron porosity value around 18. So we know that one box is equal to 15. So one box is showing the variation by 15, 45%, 30%, and 15%. So neutron value is slightly higher than the 15% value, so it is around 18%. So zone number 1 at zone number 11, the neutron positive value is 18. In zone number 7, the neutron positive value is lower than 15%. It is around 9. The neutron positive value is also given on this log section for your easiness to confirm your reading. But in the exams and in the exercises, the neutron paucity or density values will not be provided to you. So you have to read the values by yourself from the scale. So you read these values from the neutron log, and since we know that the neutron values as reported on the logs are in limestone unit, and hence required lithology corrections for all lithologies other than limestone. So we need to correct this neutron paucity value of zone number 7 and zone number 11. So we have this graph. On x-axis we have neutron log paucity in limestone unit. On y-axis we have the true paucity, the paucity that has been corrected from the lithology. And basically these are the lines for sandstone, limestone and dolomite. So for zone number 7, basically the neutron paucity value is 9%. So we enter from x-axis 9% and move vertically until we find the sandstone lithology. And when we cut basically at the sandstone matrix line, we move horizontally and reach to this y-axis and read the true paucity, which is 14% in this case. So the reported 9% paucity in limestone unit has 14% true paucity in sandstone. So zone number 7 has 14% paucity, not 9%. 9% paucity basically is in limestone unit. The corrected paucity or the true paucity of zone number 7 is 14%. That's how you read true paucity. Same case for zone number 11. The reported paucity in limestone unit was 18%, and you have identified that zone number 11 is sandstone. So you need to correct that paucity. So you entered from x-axis, move vertically. So from 18%, move vertically, reach to the sandstone matrix line, and from this line you move horizontally on the left side and read the true paucity of the formation from the y-axis, and the true paucity for zone number 11 is 24%. Again, this is the true paucity or the real paucity that need to be reported for zone number 11, not this 18%. So when someone asks you what is the true paucity of zone number 11, so you will say that the true paucity of zone number 11 is 24%. So the lithology correction needs to be applied for sandstone and dolomite. Generally, the lithology correction needs not to be applied for limestone unit, but somehow someone wants to apply the lithology correction. So if you apply lithology correction for zone number 1, you will be getting the same answer. For example, the 30% paucity, the 30% reported paucity in limestone unit for zone number 1, when you move upward, you will reach to limestone matrix line, because zone number 1 is limestone, and you can see the true paucity is also 30%. So zone number 1, which was limestone, the true paucity and the reported paucity both are equal. You don't need to apply lithology correction in limestone. You only need to apply lithology correction in sandstone and dolomite. So again, paucity estimation from neutron log requires prior knowledge of lithology. Same basically concept we have seen in density log, because in density log you estimate paucity from a formula, and in that formula you required matrix density before calculating paucity. So matrix density you will use once you identify the matrix you have at that zone. Similarly here, you need to identify the lithology first, and then you basically correct the reported neutron paucity into that particular paucity. Lithology identification through density neutron cross plot. This is the density neutron cross plot, and we have seen that apart from PEFLOC, this neutron density cross plot is a very useful log to identify the lithology. On x-axis you can see you have the log neutron porosity, which is called the corrected apparent limestone neutron porosity. So this is the log neutron porosity which is reported against each zone from the log. So from in on x-axis you have neutron porosity value, and on y-axis you have the bulk density. Again, this is the log bulk density that is reported on the log. So against each zone basically you will have these two values, one is for bulk density and other is for corrected apparent limestone neutron porosity. So each zone will have two values, one is for bulk density, other is for neutron porosity value. And when you plot that point, and when you basically plot that point, it will be lying somewhere in this on this graph. So if point lying on this line, if the point of bulk density and neutron porosity is lying on this line, which indicates that you have a sandstone filled with water. Similarly, if the point at any depth is lying on this limestone line, which indicates that this is the limestone filled with water. Similarly, if any point lying on this bottom left of this graph, it will indicate that that particular zone is anhydrite. Similarly, if any point is lying on the bottom right of the on the bottom right, it will indicate that this zone is the shale zone. Similarly, if any point lying on this top left section, it will indicate that it is a sandstone filled with gas. Similarly, if any point lying on the extreme left of the top graph, it will indicate that that particular zone is salt. So by plotting the bulk density and neutron porosity value of each zone, you can identify the lithologies, and sometime you can also identify the fluid content in that lithology. We will be doing example in the coming slide. So in this example, you have been asked to identify the lithologies in zone number 1, 3, 6 and 11 using the density neutron cross plot. So zone number 1, 3 and 11, 6 and 11 are given in this log section, and from log headers you can identify logs. So first you need to read the values of density neutron against each zone. So I hope you all can read the values from the log. So zone number 1 has a density value 2.2 gram per cc and neutron log value 30%. The unit of density log is gram per cc and the unit of neutron log is limestone porosity unit. So zone number 3 has a density value 2.97 gram per cc and a neutron log value is 0%. Zone number 6 has a density value 2.71 gram per cc and neutron log value around 21%. Zone number 11 has a neutron value 18% and density value is 2.3 gram per cc. So basically these values have been read from this from the log responses. For example, zone number 1 has basically density on this first line of first box, and scale we know 1.95 to 2.95. we know that one box is equal to 2.2 gram 0.25 gram per cc. So at first line of first box, the value the density value is around 2.2 gram per cc and the neutron value is 30 porosity unit. So this all values have been read from the log responses. By using this graph, basically there are four points. On x-axis you have neutron porosity and on y-axis you have density. So these are four colors representing each zone, and these four zones which are representing through these different colors have been plotted on this density neutron cross plot. So this is zone number 1, which is you can see is lying on the limestone line, indicating that zone number 1 is limestone filled with water. So only by plotting the density neutron value, neutron porosity value is 30% and the density 2.2. So 30%, 2.2, you are lying on this limestone matrix line. So by only plotting the density neutron value on this density neutron cross plot. You have identified that zone number one is limestone and the fluid in this limestone is water. Similarly, zone number three. Zone number three, when you plot the point is lying on the bottom left of this graph, showing that zone number three is anhydride. 2.97 basically is the density of this zone, and the neutron porosity value is 0%. So 0% neutron porosity value with 2.97 gram per centimeter cube density, the point is lying on the bottom left. So zone number three is anhydride. Similarly, zone number six is shale, because 2.71 and 21. So 21 basically the neutron porosity value and 2.71 is the density. So whenever the point is lying on the bottom right of this log section, it will indicate that that particular zone is the shale zone. So zone number 6 is the shale zone. Zone number 11, the density is 2.3, neutron log value is 18. So 18 neutron porosity value with 2.3 density, the point is lying on the matrix line sandstone, so indicating that zone number 11 is sandstone. So that's how you use the density neutron cross plot to identify the lithology. Again, you can identify the lithology through PEF log, the litho density log. So this log is basically confirming your results from the PEF log. So this is basically an alternative approach to identify the lithology. Other than the neutron density cross plot, we can also identify the lithologies through the responses on the logs. So every time we are not required to plot the neutron and density value on the graph and identify lithologies from the graph. There are many occasions we can identify the lithologies directly seeing the neutron density responses against each zone. So we will be basically discussing it right now. And the principle behind is that the density tool is usually run with a neutron, and to add quick look interpretation, they are run on limestone compatible scales. This means that the scales are set such that for a given clean limestone containing just water, the density and the neutron curves overlap. So 30% porous limestone will have a density of 2.20 gram per cc, and 0% porous limestone will have a density of around 2.70 gram per cc. Basically, whenever you have a limestone filled with water, the density curve and neutron curves will overlap. So that's how the scales have been chosen. And because these two curves are overlapping in limestone, they will be separated in sandstone, dolomite and shale and coal and other cases. So by knowing whether density neutron curves are overlapping or they are separated, we can identify a particular lithology with the fluid they have in their pores. So this is basically identifying the lithology through seeing the density neutron log responses on the logs. So as written over here, that both the formation density log and the neutron log gives a direct measurement of total porosity. Hence, if they are plotted on compatible scales, they should overlie each other for clean limestone formation 100% saturated with fresh water. Again, sandstone and dolomite, you will have a separation because the scales of neutron density have been chosen for limestone matrix, not for sandstone and dolomite. So for sandstone and dolomite, there will be a separation of density and neutron log, but no separation will be against the limestone matrix. And again, we will see that the separation are caused by the relative position of both logs. So when there is no separation for pure limestones, and the porosity value that the log gives is accurate. So for limestone, there will be no separation between the density and neutron log value, and the porosity values are accurate. There will be a small negative separation for clean sandstone, and there will be a moderate positive separation for pure dolomites. Next slide will explain you this. So in against shale, you will have a positive separation. A positive separation means that the neutron paucity value is on the left side, and the density bulk density value is on the right side. So when you have neutron paucity value on the higher side and bulk density values are also on the higher side, so this separation is called the positive separation. Neutron value is on the left side of the log and bulk density is on the right side of the log. Both are have the higher values. So this separation is called positive separation, and against shale you have positive separation. Against sandstone, regardless of its porosity, if that sandstone is clean, clean means it does not have any shale, you will have a negative separation. Negative separation means that now density value is on the left side and the neutron value is on the right side. Reverse separation as you see in shale zone. So against sandstone you will have negative separation. Against limestone, regardless of its porosity, regardless of its many times the fluid content, so against limestone you will have an overlap of the density and the Newton log. So and against dolomite you will have the similar positive separation. So these are basically the Newton density log responses, and only by seeing the separation or overlapping you can identify the zone. You can differentiate between shale and sandstone, you can differentiate between sandstone and limestone, you can differentiate between limestone and dolomite. Remember that shale and dolomite both have the positive separation. You can see against shale you have positive separation, and against dolomite you also have the positive separation. So how you will differentiate between shale and dolomite? Remember we have also studied the gamma ray log. So against shale you will have high gamma ray value. So when you have high gamma ray value and a positive separation, which means that this is the shale zone. If you have low gamma ray value, because dolomite has low gamma ray value, so when you have the low gamma ray value with positive separation, which means you have dolomite. PEF value can also be used. We know that against dolomite you have a PEF value around 3.2. For shale it's a variable, but it is generally between 3 and 4. So PEF value is not so much reliable in differentiating between shale and dolomite, but the gamma ray value can be used to differentiate between shale and dolomite. Shale will have high gamma ray value and dolomite will have low gamma ray value. You can also basically plot this point on the density neutron cross plot to identify each lithology. So only by knowing the separation or the overlapping you can differentiate between the lithologies. This is basically the responses against different zones. Against shale you will have a positive separation, you will have higher neutron value with higher density, so neutron log value will be lying on the left side and the density value will be lying on the right side. So this separation is called positive. Against sand, 6, 5, 4, 3, these are the four zones of sandstone with different porosities and different fluid content. So you can see regardless of the porosity and regardless of the fluid content, you will have a negative separation in sandstone. So 6, 5, 4, 3, these are different zones of sandstone, the clean sandstone. Against no shale is present in either sand or limestone. So these are zones of clean sandstone with different porosities and fluid content. So in the sixth zone, for example, has a porosity of 25% and it contains gas. So you can see that you have a big negative separation. A big negative separation, and negative separation has decreased slightly in the oil zone and the water zone. So first you have negative separation in the sandstone, and when you have a big negative separation, it is because most likely you have the gas zone in that particular sandstone. That's how you differentiate between the gas and oil zone through this density neutron responses. On the log response, when you have big negative separation, it is likely that you have the gas zone. And when you plot these density neutron log value on this density neutron cross plot, you will see that the point is lying above the sandstone zone, which indicates that you have the gas zone. So against shale you have positive separation, against the clean sandstone you will have negative separation. Regardless of the porosity, regardless of the fluid content, you will have negative separation. And negative separation means that density log value is lying on the left side and the neutron log value is lying on the right side. Against the limestone, regardless of its porosity, the both density and neutron log value will be overlapping each other, as you can see. So it is in zone number 2, which is a low porosity limestone, both the curves are overlying. In zone number 1, the high porosity limestone, both the curves are overlying. So in limestone, in clean limestone containing water, the neutron and density curves will be overlying. But in sandstone, you will have negative separation. In shale, you will have positive separation. Again, in dolomite, you will also have a positive separation, but you can differentiate between dolomite and shale through gamma ray log. So that's how you use density neutron responses to identify lithology and fluid content. So when you plot again all these points on this density neutron cross plot, shale zone will be lying on the bottom bottom right in the shale zone. Sixth zone, which was the sandstone containing gas, the point will be lying on the top left in the gas zone, indicating that it is this zone containing the gas. When zone containing water 3 and 4, it will be lying on the matrix line, sandstone containing water line. Zone number 5, which contains oil, so it will be lying just above this matrix line. So when the neutron porosity and bulk density point is lying just above any matrix line, it indicates that fluid is probably oil. And when this point is much higher than the matrix line, it indicates that it contains a gas. Zone number 1 and 2 are limestone containing water, and they are lying on the limestone matrix line. So by seeing the responses and by plotting these points on the density neutron cross plot, you can identify the lithologies plus the fluid content. And basically, when the point is lying higher than the matrix line, how you will read the porosity? So that's this is the method of reading the porosity from the matrix line. One of the use of this density neutron cross plot is to correct the neutron porosity value to get the true porosity of the gas zone. So that's basically from the point you try to reach to the matrix line, and you reach perpendicularly. Again, I have told you that the neutron density cross plot can be used to identify the gas zone, and whenever you have the big separation, a big separation between big negative separation, density is on the left side and neutron porosity on the right side. This big negative separation will indicate a gas zone, and this is also called the President law, because everyone could see it and identify the gas in the sands. So in the exam, if a question comes, what is the President law? So you need to say that President log basically is the log to identify the gas zones in the sands, and big negative separation in the sand zone will indicate the presence of gas in that sand. So we have seen that neutron tools will read lower porosity in gas zone. Why? Because gas zone has low hydrogen index and low density. So neutron tools will read lower porosity in gas zone, and density tool will also read lower in gas zone. We have seen in when we were studying in the density log that in gas zone, the overall bulk density of that zone will be lower as compared to the oil and water zone. So bulk density is lower plus the neutron porosity value is lower. So in gas zone, both the neutron paucity and bulk density values are lower, and when you plot on the log response you have a big negative separation. Again, this method is only valid in clean formation. As written over here, that in shale gas zone or deep filtration invasion, this present log cannot be used, because the obvious response will not be present in the shale zone or when you have the deep mud invasion. For example, the log response have been given to you. Again, that is the same example we have been doing the log section, and you have been identified that you have been asked to identify the gas zone in this log section using the density neutron cross plot. So we know that gas zone, again in the gas zone you will have the big negative separation. So big negative separation means density neutron responses will be separated, separated, and the density value will be on the left side and neutron log value will be on the right side. So zone number one, when you see in zone number one, both neutron and density values are overlying each other. So this is the limestone zone. Zone number two, you have a separation, but this is the positive separation. Neutron value is lying on the left side and the density value is lying on the right side. So you have a separation, but this is the positive separation, and we know that positive separation can only be in either shale or dolomite. So zone number two can be shale or dolomite, and when you see the gamma ray value, the gamma ray value is high, so zone number two is most likely shale, I think. And similarly zone number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So when you come in zone number 7, you have a low gamma ray value, PEF value is 2. So PEF value 2 means it's most likely a sandstone. Low gamma ray value, PEF value 2, and you have a big negative separation. When you compare this separation with zone number 9, 10, 11, this is a big separation. So zone number 7, 9, 11 all have low gamma ray value and all have a negative separation, but the separation in zone number 7 is larger as compared to zone number 9, 11. So zone number 7 is most likely the zone which has the gas. So this is a basically reminder that resistive log, which we haven't studied till yet, is used to differentiate between the water and the hydrocarbon bearing zone. Density neutron cross plot can only identify the gas zone, but it is not good in differentiating between the oil and water zone. Resistivity log should be used along with the density neutron log for the detection of hydrocarbon zone. For time being, we will not be using it. Against the gas zone, there is a big negative separation is seen on the density neutron cross plot. So we have identified that zone number 7 is the gas zone in this log section. Big negative separation, PEF value 2, low gamma ray value, these all are the indication of the gas zone, which is also the president log. So this is called the president log because everyone can see it. You can also confirm it by plotting it on the density neutron cross plot. In zone number 7, the density value is 2.2 gram per cc and the neutron paucity value is 9%. So you read these values from the log responses. This is the 9% value which is reported on the log. 9% neutron paucity value. Again, it is in the limestone unit, and for using this graph you need the limestone paucity unit. You do not need to correct lithology for this graph. So you need the values directly from the log, and when you point, when you place this point on this log section on this graph, 9% neutron paucity value and 2.2 gram per cc density, so you will reach to this point in the graph, and which is again confirms your interpretation that this zone is the gas zone. All the points lying in this region indicates that it is the gas zone in the sandstone. And if you need to read the porosity in this gas zone, you have to move parallel and reach to this matrix line. So this line is given to you. You need to move parallel, and when you read the value of the true porosity from the line, it turns out that the porosity is around 20%. So you move parallel to the line and reach to this sandstone line. So porosity is around 20%, around 21%. So that's how you use this density neutron responses to identify gas zone. That's how you use density neutron cross plot to confirm your interpretation and to read the true porosity in the gas zone. So as you can see, that zone number 7 point lies above the sandstone matrix line in the gas zone and confirms our prediction from the density neutron responses. The actual porosity in this lithology can be read from the density neutron cross plot, and it is equal to around 20%. So the value in this zone is around 20%. Again, the method we have discussed in the previous slide is valid for clean sands only. When you have shaly sands or you have deep invasion, this method will not be applicable because of the presence of shale in the sand. The neutron porosity value and density value, both neutron and density value, will increase. So the big negative separation will shrink because now you have higher density, so density value will move to the right. Similarly, that because of the shale, the neutron porosity value will increase, so neutron porosity will move to the left side. So density value will move to the right side and neutron porosity value will move to the left side. And depending on the percentage of the shale, whether shale is 10% or whether shale is 20%, whether shale is 50%, this big negative separation can shrink and even can bypass each other and can result in the positive separation. So because of the high shale in the sand, the apparent responses can be the positive. So for shaly sand and for the deep invasion, your interpretation is not valid, because same concept when you have mud invasion, and because of this mud invasion you have mud near well bore, and mud generally is water based mud. So because of this water invasion from your mud, your hydrogen index near well bore will increase. So now your tool is seeing the mud, and because of this seeing of mud, the density of near well bore region will increase. Similarly, the neutron porosity value will increase, so the big negative separation will shrink, and depending on invasion, it can either shrink to a very low level, or it can even be possible that you may have a positive separation in this gas zone which has deep invasion. So many times you have the gas zone, but since the zone is shaly or it has deep invasion, you cannot see the obvious president log response in the gas zone. So always keep in mind that you may not have the obvious big negative separation in the gas zone. So if the formation has shale, or even the formation is clean but you have deep invasion, you may not have this big negative separation against the gas zone.